Hello students, last time we have dealt with some uses or the applications of radioactivity and the left uses we will be discussing in this lecture. So out of the left uses, the very first that we are going to see here, that these radioisotopes or this phenomena of radioactivity can be used to find out the age of rocks or the age of earth. And this kind of age determination is done by the use of radioactive isotope of uranium, that is uranium-238. If on the basis of this uranium-238, if we go to find out the age of any rock, this kind of process is termed as geological dating. And this process of geological dating that we are to study here. So that is the very first use of radioactivity that we will be discussing here. Now this geological dating is based on the principle that all the rocks and the earth particles, they contain the radioactive isotope of uranium, that is uranium-238. With time this disintegrates and finally the end product, the stable end product of this decay series is the stable isotope of lead, that is lead-200. So by considering the amount of this uranium left, the left amount of radioactive uranium and the formed amount of this stable lead, we can find out that what is the age of this rock. Like if I apply this concept on the disintegration reaction, disintegration equation, then as we know that the disintegration equation is equals to lambda T is equals to 2.303 log base 10 N0 divided with N, where this lambda, it shows the disintegration constant, this T is the time period in which the change is going to occur, 2.303 is a constant, log is a function here, and N0, it indicates the initial amount of radioactive substance. While this N, it indicates the final or the left amount of radioactive substance. So that is the disintegration constant. Now by putting the value of N0 and N here, we can find out the time period or the age of that rock. Now as we know that the initial amount of this radioactive substance N0 is equals to the moles of uranium-238 found initially. So this indicates the moles of radioactive uranium which were present initially, but we do not have any idea that at the starting of this earth or 5000 years back, what was the moles of radioactive uranium present in this sample. So we can take the help of concept here. As we know that this uranium-238, what was present in initial, by the decay it's going to be converted into stable isotope of lead, that is lead-206. But since all the uranium is not has been converted into stable isotope of lead and some amount of uranium is left here, that I'm going to indicate by the symbol U dash, and the mass number is same, it is uranium-238. So this initial amount of uranium-238 is equals to the moles of this lead formed plus moles of this uranium-238 that are still left here. And by putting the value here, we can find out that what is the value of N0 here. Or on the other hand, if I talk about the final amount of this radioactive substance N, so here we can see that the left amount of this radioactive substance is equals to the moles of uranium-238 left. So here by putting the value of these two constants, we can find out that what will be the value of T or the time period here. This is the equals to N0 is equals to moles of uranium-238 present initially, and that will be equals to moles of lead-206 plus moles of uranium-238 that are left, that I am going to indicate by the symbol of dash here. And this N is equals to moles of uranium-238 left at that time, present at that time, that I am going to indicate by this kind of dash symbol. So by putting the value of these two variables here, we can get the disintegration equation in the form, that is lambda T is equals to 2.303 log base 10, it is N0, that is equals to moles of lead-206 plus moles of uranium-238 divided with the left amount of this radioactive sample, that is equals to moles of uranium-238. So since here we have to calculate the time period for this change, so this T will be equals to 2.303 divided with lambda, that's the disintegration constant for this radioactive uranium, log base 10, it's moles of lead-206 plus moles of uranium-238 divided with the moles of uranium-238. Now if we solve this equation, so here this disintegration constant it's not known to us, but here we can take the help of half-life period of this uranium. As we know that this lambda disintegration constant is equals to 0.693 divided with T-half, and this T-half is basically the half-life period of this radioactive uranium that will be provided to you while solving the question. So if I put the value of lambda here in this equation, the equation will come in the form 2.303 divided with 0.693 multiplied with the half-life period of this radioactive uranium. It's log base 10, and if I take the moles of uranium common from this equation, it will come like 1 plus moles of this lead-206 divided with moles of uranium-238. So that's the final equation, and by putting the value of this moles of left, moles of formed lead plus moles of left uranium, we can find out that in how much time period this change has been going to occur. And this time period will indicate the age of that earth, or that indicate the age of earth, or indicate the age of that rock particle. So that is about the age determination of rock, and this kind of age determination is termed as geological dating. Like for example, if I take a question here based on this formula, based on the geological dating, then the question is provided as, now here the sample of uranium mineral was found to contain the amount of lead and the amount of uranium in the ratio of 0.008:1, and with the help of this amount we are asked to calculate the age of mineral. As we know that in the geological dating we have derived just now that the time period of any rock sample, it can be calculated by the formula, it's T is equals to 2.303 multiplied with the half-life period of this uranium sample divided with a factor of 0.693 multiplied with log base 10, and in bracket it is 1 plus moles of lead plus moles of uranium-238. Now if I put all the given things that are given in this, so if I put all the given values in this formula, the value will come as 2.303 multiplied with the half-life period of this uranium, that is given as 4.51 × 10⁻⁹ years. We are going to divide this with 0.693 multiplied with log base 10, 1 plus, here the ratio of moles of this lead and uranium is required, but here in the question the ratio of the mass of this lead and uranium is given to us. So we will convert this ratio by mass into ratio by mole, and the conversion can be done as, till the time I am going to left this equation here, as we know that the ratio by mass of this lead-206 to this uranium-238, it is provided to us as 0.008:1. Since we have to convert this into ratio by mole, this can be done by dividing this ratio by mass with their atomic masses correspondingly. So the 0.008, it indicates the amount of lead here, and as we can see in the formula, the mass number of this lead is 206, that can be used as the mass of this, that will be 206 AMU. Ratio with 1 to the mass of this uranium, that is 238, since we are going to use this isotope of uranium with the mass number 238. So as we go for the solving on this equation, the final answer will come as in the form 0.0092. So this is the ratio by mole to this lead and uranium, and this was the thing required in this disintegration equation. So as I put the value here, the value will come as 0.0092. as I solve the equation here, this T is equals to 2.303 multiplied with the half-life period, that is 4.51 into 10 to the power 9, divided with 0.693, that's the constant value, multiplied with log base 10. And as in the initial equation we have seen that we are to take the log of 1.0092. As we have solved this just now, the value comes as, the ratio comes as 0.0092. So we are to take the log of 1.0092. So here I am going to put the value, it is 1.0092. As we take the log of this, by using the log table, the value comes here as 0.00397. So this value I have written with the help of log table, and as I put the value here, on solving this simple equation we can get that what is the age of this rock sample. This time period of this rock, or the age of this rock, on solving the equation, the value comes as 5.945 into 10 to the power 7 years, and this value indicates the age of this rock sample. So that is about the geological dating. Now if we move for the next use of this radioactivity, then with the help of these radioisotopes or with the help of radioactivity, we can also determine the age of any fossil. And for the age determination of any fossil, we use the radioactive isotope, that is C614, and by using this radioactive carbon, if we go for the age determination of any fossil, this process is termed as radiocarbon dating. This radiocarbon dating is based on the principle that in nature both the radioactive isotope and normal isotope of carbon are found. In nature, this carbon exists in the form of carbon dioxide, and in this carbon dioxide, one molecule contains this normal carbon, that with the formula CO2, where the another form of carbon dioxide is found by using radioactive isotope of carbon, that is C614. And when these carbon dioxides are used by plants in the process of photosynthesis, so in the process of photosynthesis, these both carbon dioxides are incorporated in the compound of carbon, that is the formation of food, or that is found in the form of sucrose. When these plants, when these plants are eaten by animals, this radioactive carbon is now incorporated into animals, and by the digestion of this food, that this food is taken by animal, and by this process, this animal contains now this radioactive carbon. Now as this animal goes for the process of digestion here, by the process of digestion, this radioactive carbon is converted into again in the form of carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide in the process of respiration is exhaled out again to the environment. So we have seen here that this radioactive carbon that we are getting from the environment is again given by the animals to this environment. And by this, the ratio of C14 to C12 is maintained in animals, in plants, or any living organism, since they are continuously going to consume this radioactive carbon, as well as by the process of respiration they are going to exhale this radioactive carbon to the environment. So the ratio of this C14 to C12 is maintained in any living organism, and this ratio is found to be equal to the ratio of C14 and C12 that is found in the environment. Now it is considered that the ratio of C14 to C12 in the atmosphere, it has been constant for at least 50,000 years. So with the help of this data, that this ratio remains constant in the environment for the time period of 50,000 years, we can find out the age of any fossil which has a time period of approximate 50,000 years. And for the calculation of the age of this fossil, again we will take the help of disintegration equation. As according to the disintegration constant, lambda t is equals to 2.303 multiplied with log base 10 n0 divided with n, where this n0, it indicates the initial amount of radioactive substance, and this n0, initially what was the amount of this radioactive carbon in the human being, that we can compare from the ratio of C14 to C12 in atmosphere. So this N0 will be equals to ratio of C14 to C12 found in any green plant or in atmosphere. While if I talk about N, so this is the ratio of C14 to C12 find at the present time, and that is the ratio present in the fossil. So by finding this ratio of C14 to C12 in atmosphere can be judged any time, and to find out the ratio of C14 to C12 what's there in the fossil, we take the small piece of this fossil, we burn this to produce carbon dioxide gas, and by analyzing this carbon dioxide we can find out that what will be the ratio of C14 to C12 at the present time in this fossil. Now here to calculate this lambda, we can write this equation as lambda is equals to 2.303 divided with lambda, and this lambda is equals to 0.693 multiplied with the t half of this radioactive carbon multiplied with log base 10 n0 by n. We have seen initially that what's the value of this n0 and n here, and for the half-life period of this carbon, radioactive carbon, the half-life period of this radioactive carbon has a fixed range, and the range is 5570 plus minus 30 years. So that's about the range of this half-life period of this carbon. Now what will be the exact value of this half-life that can be taken according to the range, or that will be provided you by dealing with the questions. So by putting the half-life period and the value of N0 and N here, we can find out the age of that fossil, or the time period in which this change has been occurred, and that time period is termed as the age of that fossil. And this process of age determination of any fossil is termed as radiocarbon dating.